We just want to give you a little hope here from the Kentucky Derby
Museum.
It's
not going to be like yesterday. It's going to be different conditions.
It's going to be much different.
It already feels different out here. So you just have to bundle up in layers, but it won't be quite as bad. We're going to get more to your forecast coming up. But right now, we have some fun for you with the CEO, the original CEO.
Exactly. He lights up the room.
How are you, Doug and Renee? I'll tell you what. And this will probably warm you up. I've got a cocktail that will actually help warm things up.
Or put us to sleep.
Yeah. You guys have a long day, so I know you can't sample this.
Oh, yeah, that's right. We got it.
I'll take it through for you.
Yeah, let's introduce you again. This is our CEO, the Chief Entertainment Officer, Tim Laird.
And we should say you're with Brown Forman.
You bet.
You do have a job. Everybody always wonders, what kind of job does Tim have?
It's a real job.
You're a connoisseur of wines.
And
spirits and champagne.
Exactly.
And you're also a gourmet chef.
I love to do it. You know, one of the things is entertaining is a hobby of ours. We love to do it. It's just fun. And I always like to do recipes that are easy, that everybody could emulate and do at home. So, and I always say, when you entertain, make sure you take the stress out of it, because you as a host or hostess should have as much fun as everyone at the party. So I always say, do as much ahead of time, make things easy, don't make it hard on yourself, just have fun.
So today we are talking about the bourbon balls, and we are making a new version of the bourbon balls?
Yeah, it's amazing. I was doing a cocktail seminar, and this person comes up and says, you know, I really don't like bourbon, but I love the bourbon ball candies. And I go, well, if I can make a cocktail that would taste like the bourbon ball candies, maybe I'll be onto something. So this is it. This is the liquid version of those famous bourbon ball candies. And it starts out, 1.5 ounces of Woodford Reserve goes in, a little shaker of ice. Boom, just about like that.
Now, should you,
and
should
on a cold day, you could have a little bit more.
should you have your cell phone nearby to call 911 fast if you have one of these?
That's right, exactly. And then, all of a sudden, the chocolate part, a little chocolate liqueur, about 3/4 ounce of that. And, of course, the pecan nut on top. I have a little bit of nut liqueur. You can get pecan or hazelnut, whatever you have. Just those ingredients, real easy. A nice little shake. My favorite sound in the morning. How about that? I hear that sound, I get excited. All right, it's like they're off. And strain that into a little cocktail glass. And this makes a nice little dessert, if you want, just to sip on and something fun. But it really does taste exactly like the bourbon ball candies.
Now, Tim, you have a lot of fun. You talk about that's your favorite sound in the morning. But you actually have a very simple Kentucky Derby, the way you spend it personally.
Right.
Tell our folks what you will do, where will you spend your Derby, and how you will end it at 6:46 tonight.
Here's what I'll do. Before the Derby race goes off, I run outside of the track, get in my car, go home, and usually on a warm day, I'll put some shorts on, grab a beverage, and then turn on the TV and watch it from home. I go, wow, I beat the traffic, and what a day. So that's how I spend my Derby. Nothing glamorous or anything else, but I always look forward to that. And, of course, my favorite day, Sunday. That's when we get a little rest. All of us can rest in a little bit.
Well, and great.
Your favorite Derby meal? What will be tonight?
You know what? Here's what's real easy. I love it, talking about entertaining. Simply buy some country ham, good old Kentucky country ham, and get a little biscuits or a nice little bun, and then put a little Dijon mustard with a little bit of bourbon in it. It just kicks up that mustard, and it tastes great. You can make those sandwiches ahead of time, set them out, let your guests serve themselves. That's a Derby entertaining tip for you. Real easy.
And that sounds stress-free and low-key.
Stress-free. Easy, stress-free, and people love it.
All right, one more time for the folks that are out there that are watching, that are putting together the finishing touches on their Derby parties. Again, the mix is an ounce of the Woodford Reserve.
1.5 ounces of Woodford Reserve, about 3/4 ounce of chocolate liqueur, and just a splash or about 1/4 ounce of nut liqueur. So that's it. Chocolate, bourbon, and nuts.
The chief entertaining officer already in the house here. We're not even at 8:30. Coming up next, we're going to join our Kent Spencer. He's been on the backside talking to some of the trainers. You want to hear from him. We're going to hear from Doug O'Neill, who has IRAP, the Bluegrass